Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm Aaron Knightley. Today I'm super excited because I'm going to be sharing with you my thoughts, opinions about the 2021 property crash. We're in a recession right now, and next year I really believe that we're going to see house prices drop and landlords sell. And in this video, I'm going to explain exactly why and how I believe that we need to maximize and look at the opportunity and go on to actually purchase these discounts. We're going to see discounts we've not seen before. So stick around, because in this video, I'm going to explain exactly why. Now, before we start, guys, I just want to say that these are my own thoughts and opinions. I'm no expert by any means. However, what I'm going to share with you today and my predictions of this crash come from a place of knowledge. They do come from a place of real life case studies, being involved kind of firsthand, and also really in-depth discussion with quite high caliber investors who are going to be selling portfolios, which I'm going to go on to explain, due to the pain that we've seen through this year of 2020 due to the effects of COVID. So I think it's fair to say we are in a recession right now. I think we can all agree on that. And if we're keeping this within the property market, because the economy as a whole isn't looking great, but with the property market, we are in a mini boom. This is not a true reflection of what the market is like on an everyday basis. It's just not. So the mini boom has been stemmed really from the media hyping it up. We've had the furlough scheme, the bounce back loans, where you know, real estate investors who have seen that as an opportunity and fair play have basically said, right, I've got a load of free money. I'm just going to go invest in property because it's free money. Whether there's going to be, repercussions down the line of when all this tax relief ends and they start recalling bounce back loans, we're not quite there yet, so we don't know. However, they have gone on to basically purchase more assets. Now, that was an opportunity that people have taken. So the tax relief will end, the furlough scheme will end. Ultimately, this will then bring the property market down, you know, because all of this will end, that the hype will, the bubble will burst, as they say. So it's really been blown up. It's not a true reflection. So what's going to happen? Well, we've seen unemployment. We're going to see further mass unemployment. And going on into next year, although we're going to see this crash, what does that bring? That brings opportunity if you are a real estate investor, a switched on investor who sees this as an opportunity. Now, what I believe is going to happen is when we go into 2021 and we see all this tax relief end, the stamp duty come back into play, capital gains possibly going up, we're going to see all these changes because we need, how's the government, they need to make their money back is what I'm trying to say. So that's going to hit us in other ways. And unfortunately, conversations that I've certainly had, and this comes from the opportunity that's going to be on the table, is landlords have gone through a lot of pain this year. Property investors have felt, you know, that they've been punched quite hard this year due to the effects of COVID-19. So many landlords who own large portfolios have had to bend over backwards for tenants. They've had to give rental relief. They've had to really sort of jump the hoops to try and keep their portfolios afloat. So tired, distressed portfolios and landlords who have been in the game for a long time are basically 2020, they were thinking, right, okay, the first quarter, second quarter, it's been really painful. However, I've worked so hard to keep hold of this portfolio. I really don't want to let it go. So they've really sort of pushed through the pain. However, we're getting to the end. And let's face it, the signs are not looking great, in my opinion, for 2021 either, which really annoys me, but it is what it is. So a lot of landlords now, I believe, and conversations that I've had, they're saying, you know, we've really gone through the struggle of 2020. If this continues in 2021, you know, we're down on the mortgages, we've practically made no income, no profit, mass unemployment, especially in the north. Therefore, nothing's really been going in the pocket. The property portfolios has been costing a hell of a lot of money to these bigger landlords with larger portfolios. So what's that going to bring in 2021? When all this comes crashing in, landlords will go, I've had enough. I'm not holding on to this portfolio. I've had it for 30, 40, 50 years. You know, perhaps the portfolio is mortgage free, perhaps it's not. You know, the ones that are mortgage, do have a mortgage on the portfolio, you might even see better deals. You might even see even better deals, discounts we've not even seen before from the ones who are completely mortgage free because they've made a killing over the years. 2020 was a really bad year. And now they said, enough is enough. I'm selling the whole portfolio. So we now have an opportunity. So how can we find these deals? Well, that's something that I'm going to jump into in part two. But what we do need to do is we need to really start looking at the opportunity that we might be able to pick up some discounts that we have just not seen before. Right, okay, so the next steps. Guys and girls, please note this down because this is super important, this next part, and I really want you to apply these 2 points that I'm going to explain now. So the first point is the discounts are coming. However, how do we understand, whatever part of the country you're in, how do we understand what the investors, the landlords are going to be doing for the property crash that is only around the corner in 2021? What I want you to do is what I've already done. And that's why I have this good overview and kind of background scene of what's going to be happening and what I believe will be the prime time to buy, is speak with as many landlords and investors as you can and understand what their pain has been during 2020 and what they're going to be looking to do in 2021. Because this will give you a real life image of what's happening. Because landlords have been through a lot of pain in 2020. They've lost a lot of money. And some of them will go, enough is enough, I'm selling. So we need to understand when they're selling, what part of the portfolio they're going to be selling. And for us, this offers two opportunities. One being that we can either look to purchase these discounted properties, but if perhaps we don't have the capital or the resources to go and optimize and actually purchase, then we could look to move it on to another investor. If you know investors that are thinking, right, I'm going to be cash rich for next year, and you know someone that's selling, could you perhaps link the two up and you'd be the middleman and then you start making some cash yourself? So that's 2 points that you need to really look at. The second point, what I want you to do, and note this down, is crunch your numbers. There is no better time now to money manage for the opportunities next year. So if you're spending far too much going out on food, ordering takeaways, whatever, it needs to stop and you need to start putting that into your buy-to-let investment pot, into your bank account, because we need to start building this pot up. Now, what I will be explaining, because this is part one of a part three episode, in episode three, which will be out on Sunday, I will be sharing with you ways in which you can start building and generating lump sums of cash. Everyone can do this. This isn't something that requires you to be a millionaire, a really rich business partner in the background, have rich parents, none of that. This is something that everyone can start if you have the initiative and the will to go on and do it. So we are going to be jumping into part two very shortly. I'm going to wrap this video up, but please go and apply the points that I've just mentioned. Do hit the like and subscribe button because I'm really excited to share the next 2 parts of this 3-part episode, because I really believe that we have the opportunity to get onto the buy-to-let property market. If you're already not, and if you are a real estate investor, the prime time is now. So guys, please do join me in part two. I'll eventually have the link put up here where you can just click and jump straight onto part two, and we will wrap it up there, and I'll see you in part two.